No organization is responsible for the content of this video. All errors and omissions are the sole responsibility of myself, David Iverson. This video must not be your only source of information. Please attend official USSA educational opportunities. Please download official USSA educational materials.
Okay, so I just want you to take a little bit of look at some GS before I talk about GS. And one thing that I forgot to mention in my slalom video is that this is posted on the USSA East YouTube channel. And so the USSA East website has really done a good job, and you should go there and see what they have on offer.
Okay, so this is a video on gatekeeping GS, or sort of understanding GS. And so rather than sort of, I'm kind of giving you a little schematic of looking up the hill. And in some of my other videos, you can see, you guys should be familiar with what a GS course looks like. And when you're out on the hill, it's pretty obvious. Okay, so I don't have colors here. But we're going to say that these are red, blue, red, blue, and those are going to be the actual colors that they are out on the hill. And I'm going to call this an inside gate, and I'm going to call this an outside, and so this is in, out, in, out, in, out. Okay, so basically the race line is gonna come something like that. That's what the racer should do. So this line is should, otherwise known as fast. Should doesn't mean must. And this is the key point of this video. Should and must are different. Okay, so when you hear about inside, we need a red outside. Well, the inside gate, that's the one that the racers are going to be up tight against, because that's going to be the quickest way down the mountain. The outside gate is just kind of hanging out, and what it does is it defines a plane. So and that plane must be crossed by two ski tips and two boots. Okay, so that plane must be crossed by two ski tips and two boots. So if I do some more wonderful artwork here for you. Okay. Boom, 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 boom. I'm doing wonderful artwork here. No, let's make them go over here even further. Okay, so what are we looking at here? Okay, in my wonderful drawing here, I have sort of, you can see all kinds of photos of this. This is exactly the sort of the pose that everybody takes all their photographs of. And so basically, I have a racer who's jamming this gate. So they're bent over and they're slamming this gate. Now, this pole right here, that's the inside, that's where the plane starts, and that's where the plane ends. Now, the majority of this person does not break the plane from that pole to that pole. The majority of that person is to the inside of that. And they've pushed these little flexible gates out of the way to make that happen. But the key thing is, right in here, is that both of their ski tips and both of their boots are going to cross that plane from where that pole is located in the ground to where that pole is located in the ground. So, if they... all they have to do is two ski tips, two boots, and it doesn't matter what the rest of their body is doing as long as the two ski tips and the two boots are going from there, is going along that plane. Okay, so then we're going to look at this again, and I said that should in this case means fast, but it does not equal must. So here I had a red, blue, and so now here I got the exact same thing, red, blue, and should does not equal must, and speed is optional. Okay, so a person comes in, and then they go down through here, and then they come up, and then they go down. Okay. This line is okay. It's not fast. It's not fast, but it meets the requirements. They have broken that plane. They have broken this plane. They actually broke it twice. They broke that plane. And they've broken that plane. Okay, so legal. Okay, so legal is that each plane is broken at least once in either direction. They can, and I want to put it in any order. They can take the gates in any order that they want, and they can break the planes in any direction that they want, and they have to break each plane at least once. That is the rule. Now, there's a fast way to do that, but speed is optional. They can do it any way they want. They don't have to come over the top. They don't have to come over the top if you have two gates. Okay, so another thing that I want to put is, single pole slalom is different, and I'm going to do a whole long video on single pole slalom. So we're just talking about standard giant slalom or super G or downhill. You really only have to worry about GS, giant slalom, because at super G and downhill is going to be much more obvious. Nobody can hike in super G or downhill. But in giant slalom, or if you've got double pole slalom, Don't worry about that. I'm going to talk about single pole slalom and double pole slalom later. If you've got an inside pole and an outside pole, that defines a plane. If you've got a series of planes, then the only rule is that each plane must be broken at least once in either direction in any order. So, let's see. That's legal. Okay, I don't want to complicate things too much. That's just something on gate judging GS. And one more thing on GS is, so this is giant slalom, otherwise known as GS. And right now, you're going to see this scenario every once in a while. There's going to be one or two or three of these, probably between one and two, maybe three of these, in most courses. And so they're going to come into a red, and then there's going to be kind of two gates stacked on top of each other, sort of. And then there's going to come out, so it's going to go red, blue, red, blue. And the natural race line is going to be like this. So, well, they actually kind of DQ'd there. They got to come over like that. So they break that plane, then they break this plane, then they break this plane, and then they break this plane. Okay, so we're going to call this... There's a few different names you can call it. You can call it an undergate. Well, this one here. That's an undergate. Or it's a delay. And then you might also have it, it might also be called a corridor. And corridor is more for super G and downhill. But so if you're out on the hill, you might see a situation where they go, and I'll show a video of that in a little bit, but you're going to have a situation where they come around and it kind of looks like, wait a second, shouldn't they be doing something like this? But no, that kind of messes them up, because then they haven't broken this plane, right? Or maybe they should do like that, but then how do they get over here? So they gotta break this plane, break that plane, and then they gotta get over here. So they're gonna come out and they're gonna take a bigger swooping turn, and then they're gonna come over here, and so they're gonna have to sort of delay their turn, or they're gonna have to go under this gate. So it's an under or a delay, or in super G or downhill, you'd sort of hear it referred to as a corridor.
Okay, so GS, same thing. We've got red panels and we got blue panels. And so right now we have, she's just finished a blue. And so there's an inside, she went around the inside blue, and off on the outside where there's nothing really going on, there's the outside blue, and then she's gonna come in, and right there she's broken the plane, probably right there she's broken the plane between the red inside panel and the red outside panel, so she's broken that plane, and we're gonna come down through. And now we gotta watch very carefully, because right at the very, very end of this clip, there is an undergate. So we have to see that undergate when it comes on up. And it's not so easy to see. But there it is, right there. Okay, let's look at the undergate again. So there she broke the plane between the two red panels. There's a red panel and there's a red panel. And so she is turning to her right as she goes between the red panel and the red panel. Now she goes a little bit further, and right there, there's a blue panel and a blue panel, and so she's broken the plane between the blue panels, also turning to her right. So these 1, 2, 3, 4, that constitutes an under gate. And technically speaking, the blue is the under. So the red is just a standard GS gate, and then the blue constitutes the under.